What's up, guys? Welcome back to I Like Collectibles. I just wanted to take a quick look at this upcoming Heritage auction. There are a few specific books in this auction that I'd like to take a closer look at. There's a Detective Comics 7.0 restored, an Action Comics 1 6.5 also restored, and a Captain America Comics number 1 Promise Collection that comes in at a 3.5. As always with Heritage, these are all CGC books. So let's dive in, take a closer look. All right, so let's take a look first at Action Comics number 1. As you can see, it does have some extensive restoration. The restoration includes a small amount of color touch on the cover. Pieces have been added to the cover and interior. Tear seals to the cover and interior. Spine split has been sealed. Cover and interior reinforced and cover cleaned. Now, one thing a lot of people look at is whether the restoration can be reverted back to the original state. With cover cleaning, unfortunately, there's nothing you can do. Sometimes you can fix some of these items, like the color touch and pieces added. Oftentimes you can go back and remove those items. Let's take a closer look at the GPA for this book. Now, because it's an Action Comics number 1, there's not going to be a whole lot for sales. If you don't have GPA, I definitely recommend it. It's only $10.95 a month and pays for itself over and over. So let's take a look. Now, as you can see, there's not that many sales of Action 1 in restored grades. Let's take a look at the couple books that have sold in the last 12 months. There was a CGC 9.0 that sold for $452,000. As you can see, the grading came at an MP, which means a moderate amount of restoration. The P unfortunately stands for poor, meaning that the restoration was done poorly. Now, given the grade of 6.5, it looks like this book will break well into the 500,000 range. The all-time high for a restored Action Comics number 1, $528,000. Do you think this Action 1 will break the highest sold record? I think it has a good shot. Leave your comments below and let me know what you think. Now let's take a look at Captain America Comics number 1 pedigree. Here's a closer look, as you can clearly see the label in the book. At first glance, it presents extremely well for a 3.5. Let's take a look at the back of this one. You can see some staining and a few other defects, but for a 3.5, it looks pretty good. Now let's take a look at what comparable books sold for. As you can see, there's only a few pedigree books that have sold. There's a San Francisco, Kansas City, Windy City, but those are much higher graded than the book that we're looking at here. We're looking at a 3.5. Now, the most recent Captain America 1 happens to be a 4.0, which is extremely close in grade to the book that we're looking at. Although it's not a pedigree, it is a universal grade, meaning that there's no restoration and the book is 100% complete. That book went for $180,000. I think that it's going to be north of 180. I think it gets closer to 200,000. Let me know below what you think. Lastly, let's take a look at the Detective Comics 27. Again, this is a CGC 7.0 with extensive restoration. Restoration includes color touch, pieces added, tear seals, spine split seals, reinforced cover, cleaned, and interior has been lightened, meaning they've used the bleaching technique to lighten the pages. Again, this book presents extremely well for a 7.0. Let's take a look at the back cover. Looks pretty good. Now let's take a look at comparable sales. Again, I've already opened this so it shows just the restored titles. So we're going to scroll down, see if there's any recently sold books. Unfortunately, there has been no restored Detective Comics 27 books. The most recent sale I could find is in 2018. So it's going to be really hard to pinpoint what we think this book will end at. The last 7.5 sold in 2011 for $101,575, as you can see here. I think it's safe to say that this sale will easily double that number. Will it break $250,000? That I don't know. Again, leave your comments down below. Let me know what you think. I'm really looking forward to this auction. There's still a few weeks until it ends. So I'm going to be watching closely as there are multiple cool books in this one. Prices have been skyrocketing in the last few months, and I'm interested to see if this Heritage auction continues that trend. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel. That really does mean a lot to me. Also, check me out on Instagram at ILikeCollectibles. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment or leave me a message personally. I would love to hear from you. See you next time, guys.